Hey, I'm EveAnna Manley at Manley Labs, and today we walked in here and one channel was out. So how do we figure out why that channel went out?
I don't know.
Well, first off, here's the channel going out. I got nothing on the right side. Gosh, what do I do? Well, first, you know, in your whole system, sometimes it's a good idea to swap the cables to see if the problem follows the cable. Okay, let's give it a go. So, swapping the cables. Let's see if I still got sound on the... Okay, it's still playing there. And I'm still dead on the right side. Okay, I could swap the output cables, but for this video, we're gonna say, well, guess what? The Massive Passive, there's something wrong with the right channel. Because it's playing when I'm in bypass, but when I put it in, one channel's out. What do I do? Okay, what we do is we power down the unit. We let the tubes chill out for a second. Presumably, you would have your lid on the unit. So in order to remove it, these guys on these Pro Audio units, there's either one screw or two in the back. And what you do is you undo the screw and slide the top cover off the unit. That's easy to do. All right, the tubes have cooled down. What we're gonna be doing here is we've got two channels. We've got left channel and right channel. So we're gonna swap the tubes one at a time until the problem switches sides, and then we'll know it was that tube. Okay, I like to start with the first tube in the signal path, the one doing most of the heavy lifting, the gain tube. So in this case, it's going to be the little short guys in the middle. Now, I want y'all to be careful. Now, don't be touching all this stuff in here or you might get a shock. So the first thing you're going to do is unplug the unit, right? All right, don't touch things in here. Capacitors hold charge and they can bite you. You probably won't die, but you won't be very happy either. We're going to take, sometimes you can use a cloth or some gloves, or I like using those of gloves that you have in your kitchen. But you're going to take the tube and just grasp it and just gently wiggle it out, just like you're going to wiggle out a tooth. There we go. Okay, there's the one that was on the right channel. I'm going to do this barehanded here because it's not that hot. I'm going to wiggle this puppy out. There's that. Now I'm going to swap them, okay? So the one that was in the left channel, I'm putting in the right. So this little 5751. And I'm going to line up the pins and wiggle them in. Look really carefully here. You have a space between pin 1 and 9. That's called the key. And then in the socket, you have a space corresponding. And so we're going to line them up and wiggle them in. Okay, good. Plug the unit back in to the power. Turn on the tunes, power them back up. Let's see if the problem, so we were off on the right side, let's see if now we're off on the left side. If that side's muted now, then we found our problem, it was that guy. If not, we gotta keep changing tubes. Wait for this to warm up. Okay. Well, it's not that tube because I still have tunes playing in the left channel. Okay? So let's unplug the unit and we're going to try one of the output tubes. Right. The output tubes get a little hotter actually, so I'm going to totally use my cloth here. So I'm going to swap the in this unit, I'm going to swap the two inside output tubes because they're performing the same function in the circuit, left channel and right channel. Notice I'm like placing it purposefully far away so I don't get them mixed up. Only change one thing at a time when you're trying to diagnose this. You don't want, that's why we're not changing all the tubes at one time or we won't know which one it was. Okay, now we've got, this used to be the right side, now it's the left side. Wiggle, wiggle, There he goes. Let's plug him back in. Give him a second to warm up. He's got a mute timer on his output, so we have to wait a few seconds for the mute timer to fire off. It's in bypass right now. Okay, now we're mute. Oh my goodness. Hey, the problem just switched sides. Now, I have songs coming out the right channel, and the left channel's dead. So guess what? It was that tube. Okay, so how do I know what tube to change? Gonna power him down again. Well, we can look in our owner's manual. We can look on the website. We can go to tubesrule.com and, you know, see what tubes. But sometimes over the years, we've changed tubes. If you just want to replace that one bad tube, well, let's get them out of here. Wait a minute. Which one was it now? This is the bad tube. That's right. Got to remember. Okay. This is my bad tube. Because the problem switched when we change this. What is he? He's a 12BH7 electroharmonix. So you can go to tubesrule.com and buy one of these that will be tested for best use in a massive passive. Include your serial number and they'll test one in a unit just like yours and it will work. So thanks again, guys. Now we know how to diagnose a bad tube.